We have a lot of new faces on this channel. And I feel like for those of you who have been subscribed now for a while, you guys have had an opportunity to see, you know, the business, personal, and a lot of the other things that went on in my life outside of actually bodybuilding. And I think more specifically, my channel has grown tremendously based off of the things that have been going on in my bodybuilding career. And that's amazing. But I also want to give you guys a little bit more insight on who I am as a person, what I have going on in my life. And I figured the best way to do that was allow you guys to ask the questions that you want to know. So I put a poll on my story about 2 days ago, and I got a lot of good questions from it. I let Johnny completely pick all the ones that he thought might be the best and most fitting for, you know, this, like, you guys getting a chance to know me, learn me, and grow with me. And I want to dive in a little bit deeper and hit a lot of different aspects of my life. My only request from him was to just make it, you know, well-rounded, you know, not just bodybuilding, you know, not just personal life, not just business, just accumulation of everything. So a new subscriber could have a good understanding of who I am and my values. But nonetheless, we have a list of questions here. I'm not sure if I'm gonna get through them all, but really good questions. And this is my first time seeing them. So we're just gonna jump right into the first one. So what is your dream sponsorship? It's a good question. So I currently work with Alphalete as well as Ghost. I've been with them for a very long time. You guys were asking me this question in the past when I was just coming up. There was no question in my mind Alphalete and Ghost would be at the top of my list. But for those of you who've been following along for a while, you guys know my caffeine addiction. I have to say Wawa has been my dream sponsorship over the past maybe 4 or 5 years. And I am doing everything in my power. I'm writing letters and emails to corporate. I'm tagging them in my Instagram post. Wawa, hands down, would be my dream sponsorship. I have become addicted to coffee over the past 3-4 years. And ever since then, it's been a part of my routine to get coffee every morning. I've made friends with the local Wawa employees to the point where they watch my shows online. They have like a massive celebration when I first ever qualified for the Olympia. You know, when I got married, it was a massive announcement in the store when I walked in for me and my wife. It was just so many cool little things that have grown for me to be a part of that brand. It sounds crazy and dramatic, but it's true. Like, I've been attached to that brand for a long time. They have quality people who work there and even better coffee. So I would definitely die for a Wawa sponsorship. What is your favorite off-season meal? And I'm gonna keep this one short and sweet because if you know, you know. Ground beef, white rice, peanut butter, honey, banana with salt. Guys, if you haven't tried that yet, I'm telling you guys right now, give it a try. It'll change your life. It is the best combination of food. The thing about bodybuilding and prep, when you're in prep and you are limited to the variety of foods that you have, you will find ways to maximize the flavor and just the options that you have. That combination will forever change your life. But when it comes to the beef, you kind of got to cook it a little longer than most normal people would, right? You got to get that texture a little crunchy. You got to put the peanut butter and banana in the microwave at the end, kind of make it a little soft, put the salt on it, guys. It'll change your life. How do you manage running your businesses, social life, content creation, and bodybuilding? And truthfully, it took a while for me to learn how to navigate and be effective and efficient in all of these things, because everything that I just listed is damn near a full-time job. The content creation. I have a certain amount of videos that I need to get out every single week. Why? Because I like seeing the channel grow. Not only that, it also funnels opportunities for my other businesses. So the best form of marketing is me being consistent on social media. And then we have the actual businesses in themselves in coaching. Coaching is hands down the most time consuming job that I have. It's the one that honestly I love the most, simply because I get a chance to help and guide others doing something that I'm passionate about for them to do the same. And that I would have to say is truly, you know, my most focused that I am in at any time of the year, you know, because again, not only is team reform, you know, just, you know, me as a coach, but it's so many others as well. We have an amazing coaching staff on our team. We have a crazy amount of clients who truly find value in what we preach. And also they put a lot of their emotions and trust in us in order to guide them through their journey, you know, and it's not easy because a lot of times as coaches, we're going through a very similar journey, right? So anybody who's a bodybuilder knows, like, hey, you know, your bodybuilding emotions go up and down throughout the process of a prep. So because of that, you're not only managing your own, you're also managing clients and allowing them to stay even keeled while you're also trying to do the same on your end, right? So I also believe that the reason why I'm a good coach is because, you know, I've learned so much through being active in bodybuilding, you know? So it's definitely not easy. And then obviously we have Manifest, which is the newest of all and probably the craziest and most successful launch of any company that I've ever had. It's insane. You know, social media, it took a lot just to get to where we are. We're not massive by any means, but it took a lot of time and effort and failing to get to where we are. Coaching, it took time to build that, right? I was working a full-time job before I started to, you know, indulge into coaching. And it took almost a year and a half of me being, you know, a coach and working a full-time job before I made that jump. So it took time to build. And then same thing, you know, with bodybuilding, right? Like, you don't just start making money as a bodybuilder. Like, I mean, shit, I don't make any money really as a bodybuilder, especially with the expenses that it takes to be a bodybuilder. You know, that's probably just the most time consuming. That also, you know, funnels everything else. But nonetheless, Manifest has been the most eruption I've ever had in my life in terms of success. And it does take a lot of time and effort, but I guess the simplest way to answer all of this is delegation. You know, like I said, I have a coaching staff and I have a business partner in Chase who helps me manage all of the team reform activities. You know, the back end, you know, I have my wife who basically is the manager of all of my brands to allow me to, you know, maximize my efficiency and focus on the vision and the marketing and really on, you know, on my clients, making sure that I'm you know, involved in those day to days. And then, you know, with content creation, I have Johnny, and Johnny is somebody who truly allows me to do what I'm passionate about and speak the words and give it to you guys raw, pause, but also paint it back in a way that's, you know, digestive for entertainment. And he's a wizard at it, man. And I wouldn't be where I am without him. And the same thing with Trey, my graphic designer, and, you know, my business partner Dorian for Manifest. You know, it takes a village. It truly does, you know? And then that also allows me to focus on me being the best bodybuilder. And then that also allows me to focus on me being there for my clients. You know, I'll say this, it is delegation. And then from there, I would have to say it's mastering your schedule. You know, I'm a robot. My days are very similar day to day. And it's just really important that I stay true to my robotic schedule, because that allows me to be efficient in all the avenues that I need to be. And then having people there to lean on when needed, it allows me to be efficient. What do you need to improve in order to win the Olympia one day? This is a good question. You know, I feel like I think about this question pretty often. You know, I always say, I don't pray to win shows. I pray to be the best in the world. And because of that, I feel like what I've been doing over the last handful of years hasn't actually been investing into me being the best in the world, rather than just me being somebody who's good, you know, somebody who is good enough to be on the Olympia stage. But I also understand that there's still a lot of weaknesses that I have in my physique that can truly, truly be fixed and turned into strengths if I prioritize the long game. It's very hard for competitors to take time off the stage because we love competing. Like, we love stepping on stage. We love getting lean. We hate being too fat or chunky in an off season, you know, but I truly believe that with me actually being like 17 pounds under my stage cap when in proper conditioning, I have a lot of time to grow. My stage cap is 239. You know, right now, 8 weeks out from the Olympia, I weigh 239 pounds. So I know I have more time to focus and grow and put on tissue in order to stand next to the best in the world. And I think with me going into next season, I really need to understand that nobody's gonna care how long it takes for you to get there when you're already there. And when I tell myself that and I understand that and I digest those words, it makes me realize how important it is for me to take the adequate amount of time off to prioritize my weaknesses, instead of just getting marginally better to step back on stage, qualify for the Olympia, and maybe land in a second call out, you know, fighting for a first call out. You know, so going into next season, my plan as of now is to take that time off. And there's a chance that I might not even step on stage until around this time next year, you know? And I'm okay with that because I know when I am at my best and when I do, you know, close the gap between where I am and where I need to be, I'm gonna be very hard to beat. So what I need to do to win the Olympia, I need to take the time. Do you plan to have kids anytime soon? Yes, absolutely, man. And I've always been somebody who's grown up in a big family. I have 6 siblings personally. I have 4 parents. I have a mom and dad. I have a stepdad and a stepmother. And I've grown up just around and focused towards family. And my brothers have kids and my sisters have kids. And I think it's, you know, in a good time for me to prioritize growing a family. You know, I think over the last handful of years, I've prioritized growing businesses and growing my personal brands when, you know, me and my wife took the time to actually sit down and talk about it. And, you know, we're ready, you know, it's time. And that's another big reason why I want to take time off for me stepping on stage and competing next season, because I want to prioritize my health. And I also want to make sure that I'm around, you know, for when my wife is pregnant, when things get difficult for her, because she's been around for me so much through the difficulties of my prep. So I'm really, really excited. But I do plan to have young Alex's, that sound right? Little Alex's, little bodybuilders running around the house here in the next, hopefully 12, 14 months. Right now I have a lot of fur babies. So I do have kids. They're just, you know, not for my exact DNA, but yeah, definitely having kids sooner than later. What's your favorite position in bed? I knew that I was gonna get one of these questions on here. I'll be honest with you guys, I'm very lazy. I have always been a bottom. I'm king bottom, especially in prep. Like when there's food is low.
Why are we talking about this? What the fuck?
When energy is low, when food is non-existent, when cardio is increased, I'm telling you guys right now, I'm not rolling over. It's not happening. I'm staying on my back. Yeah, my wife's gonna kill me. How do you manage to cover the division that you compete in? So for those of you who don't watch much of my men's physique videos, I do a lot of analysis videos where I sit down and go over show recaps. I go over things that are going on in the men's physique division. And my main focus and goal of that is to give value, help educate, you know, a broader audience to the characters who are in the men's physique division, and simply add entertainment. You know, I always said men's physique has always been like a redheaded stepchild of the bodybuilding community. So I think with proper analysis or education on who these characters are and painting them in a picture in a positive light will then allow people to actually, you know, gravitate towards the division. You know, my good friend Hart McGrath, he motivated me to do this, but I wanted to do it in a way that was different, that was a unique perspective, you know, from an actual athlete's perspective, you know, not just necessarily a fan. But to answer the question, it's because I am a fan. You know, like I'm able to separate being a fan of the division and also being an athlete within a division. Like, I truly believe that come Olympia time, during intermission, I can easily come back and shoot a video, give you guys my true perspective as a fan, and say, this is what's happening versus, you know, how upset or happy I am about whatever happened with me. You know, because as much as I love the men's physique division and I love competing in it and I wanna be the best in the world and I'm coming for heads and necks, I promise you that. It doesn't change the fact that I first started off in bodybuilding as a fan of men's physique. And I just feel like I'm very comfortable and confident in my ability to flip the switch and, you know, talk about it. I just think that you have to be able to separate the two. It's not easy and it takes time. And there's obviously, you know, times where things might blend, but you have to be professional enough, you know, because at the end of the day, we're trying to give value back to the division. And if you have biasness come in play, then you're gonna lose, you know, the people's validation in your word, which is not good, obviously, for the content that you're creating. Why haven't you left Alphalete after they dropped all of the OGs? Johnny, you put me in the fire here. listen, I'll be honest, guys. You know, I wasn't happy when Alphalete released a lot of the people who've been a part of Alphalete for a long time. You know, I've been with the brand now for over 7 years, and I've grown through a lot of the, you know, trials and tribulations, and I've been through a lot of the highs with them, and they've invested a lot of time and effort and energy into me. And I truly believe in the vision of Alphalete. I cannot say that enough. And I know that there's been changes, and some are positive and some might be negative, you know, but I also believe that there's loyalty is everything, man. And I want to double down and emphasize this. I still believe that their quality and the actual products that they have are amongst the best in the entire fitness industry. I truly believe that in my heart of hearts. I have been around tons of brands. I've had the opportunity to work with other brands. You know, it's not even a consideration for me. I truly believe in Alphalete. I truly believe in the direction that they're pushing for and aiming for. And if they were to ever one day drop me, it wouldn't be bad blood. You know, at the end of the day, they're making a business decision. But I truly believe that the reason why I'm still with Alphalete is because, like I said about the men's physique division, I'm a fan of their products first. It's very easy for me to wear it because I would still wear their products even if I wasn't. You know, it's just something that I truly see the value in, you know, from a consumer's perspective. You know, I can confidently say this is one of their best products, or I hate this product. Like, I can comfortably say that. And, you know, Alphalete, we have a lot of good memories, man. You know, they've been there for me through a lot. They invested in me. They're my first ever sponsors, you know, when I literally had nobody, you know, nobody took a chance on me. And because of that, you know, just because they're going through some ups and downs doesn't change the fact that, you know, I'm going to, you know, be unloyal and shift my focus towards a brand that might be, you know, on the rise or the up and coming right now. It's not who I am. What's the hardest part about prep? It's not the meals. It's not the cardio sessions. It's not the training. It has nothing to do with the physical side of bodybuilding. The hardest part about prep is closing yourself off to the outside world. When you're in prep, there's like a tunnel vision that goes around everything. You know, like if you have a bad day in prep, it's very common for everything else to feel like significantly worse throughout that day. You know what I mean? Like, you have a bad weigh-in, your mood is now shifted towards, you know, a lot of negativity or unhappiness throughout the day. And it's not sustainable to allow prep that comes with this inevitable ups and downs to attach happiness to something like that. And I feel like no matter how much we as athletes know that it's not okay to do that, it's very hard not to, because we love this shit, man. Like, you cannot be a bodybuilder who wants to rise to the top and not love this. Like, there's genetic freaks out there. There's no question. And they might be able to get to a good position with half-assing. But for the 99% of people out there, if you're not all in, you might as well just be all out, because you will get humbled. You know, you don't rise in this sport by dipping your toe in. You know, you gotta go head first. And I feel like when you do that, you attach a lot of emotions to it. So those emotions oftentimes can cloud, you know, the outside things of prep. Like I said, the tunnel vision is real when you're focusing on being the best bodybuilder you can be. And that's the hardest part. It's just managing the ebbs and flows and not allowing it to affect everything else you have going on. What's your plan for the future of Manifest? Guys, we have so many things planned. You know, we're talking about potentially sponsoring athletes one day. We are bringing out classic physique shorts. We're going all in on campaigns and giving you guys an actual experience. Like, I want to build Manifest to being a community. Like, I want you guys to learn more about the division because you are subscribed and follow Manifest. You know, I don't want it just to be a place you just go to buy something. I want you to go somewhere to get value from, you know, and I also want to give you the best product physically possible. Like, we are addicted to that. So there's going to be tons of stuff. Like, we want to bring out, you know, pump covers. You know, this is actually a pump cover that we have, right? We want to bring out, you know, things that you can wear post or backstage when you're getting tanned or when you're relaxing. That's lightweight, that's comfortable, that, you know, it's just so many things, guys. And I feel like my mind is literally never turned off when it comes to Manifest. And there's just so many things coming. Like, this next launch that we're coming out with is going to be insane. And this one is going to be so personal to me. And I can talk about this forever, but just stay tuned. It's going to be It's gonna be amazing. All right, guys, that is a wrap on the Q&A. I feel like I had not done a Q&A on my YouTube channel in over 2-3 years. So hopefully you guys have found some value in it. For those of you who are new to the channel, thank you guys so much for subscribing. For those of you who are OGs to the channel, thank you guys for sticking along and following along on this journey for so long. I promise you guys, this is just the beginning. I cannot wait to continue to invest and effort and energy back into growing this channel to what I know it can be. If you can, if you're watching this right now and you aren't subscribed, please make sure that you subscribe. I promise you, it might not seem like a lot, but it helps the channel out so much. Continue to spread positivity in the comments. Again, guys, I love you guys. I appreciate you guys. And until the next video, peace.